sorry. Sorry I dragged you into this. I overthink. That's all it is.
So, how does it feel to be a free man?
Well, you took your time deciding I was innocent.
Oh yeah, it makes me king again. When I find myself in the middle.
James is lying to you.
So tell me now.
I didn't know whether to tell you or not.
So what? You saw James with the McQueens? Don't mean anything.
He said John Paul is being released today.
That's really good news.
They were thanking him for it.
He promised me he was going to drop the case.
He kept saying how nice John Paul was, like he was still in love with him.
Nah, you've got this wrong.
No, I haven't. He isn't right for you. James is never interested in me or Lucas, and he lied to your face.
You're late for school.
I don't trust him.
Well, I didn't ask for your opinion, Leah, so get up and get to school.
I told you because I didn't want you getting hurt. Wish I'd never bothered.
So how are you? Did they treat you okay inside?
Yeah, it was all right. Just kept my head down, kept out of trouble, you know? But I'm home now, thanks to Teresa.
I knew there was something shifty about that bent copper.
Can't believe he faked a witness statement.
I can. And then James worked his magic.
James thought I was guilty.
Well, he knows you're innocent now. And we knew all along. That's what counts.
Where's Matthew?
He's upstairs. Oh, he can't wait to see you. He asked a lot of questions and I couldn't answer all of them.
It all just feels so weird. Being back here, George gone. I don't really know what to do with myself now.
You're missing him. I thought you'd be pleased.
What, that my boyfriend's dead?
Well, at least he can't hurt you anymore.
Ah, a family reunited. How sweet.
What are you doing here?
I'm hoping to catch a killer.
You still got a job after faking a witness statement?
I got a smack on the knuckles, but my record's exemplary, so...
Why won't you just leave me alone? I mean, I've already been to prison for something I didn't do.
Is that so? See, I know how much George loved you. He told me. Countless times.
Don't listen, John Paul.
But he just couldn't see how damaging you were for him. The temper, the mood swings... The video of you on his tablet lashing out at my colleague, my friend.
We rowed. Couples row. But I would never hurt George. Not like he hurt me.
You're still playing the victim. This guilty conscience of yours is sickening.
I'm innocent.
You might think you've gotten away with it, but I'll get justice for George. It's only a matter of time before one of you gives the game away. I'll be ready when you do.
Now I gave the whole...
Oh, just in time. About to head out for lunch.
Busy morning.
So.
I fancy sushi.
Thought you'd be cracking open the champagne. What with one of your clients being released?
I take it, Leah spoke to you about John Paul.
So you even admit it? You helped get John Paul out of prison?
No.
What?
As I told Leah yesterday, she got it wrong.
She saw you with the McQueens.
That's right.
They were thanking you. She heard you say how much John Paul means to you.
Meant. Past tense. As in, we were friends. Look, I was just... telling them how sorry I was that I couldn't help them anymore, but didn't matter anyway because he got released.
So you didn't help get John Paul out?
Knowing how much of a problem you have with it, I mean, why would I jeopardise our relationship like that? Look, are you still feeling insecure about our chat yesterday?
No. I just want the truth.
The truth is... Leah has constantly got her head in a phone. And she looked up at 1 second, saw me with the McQueens, and she got the wrong end of the stick.
And how do I know you're not lying to me now?
You just have to trust me, Steve.
Or I could just go and find out from the McQueens.
Him skulking about like a scabby little rat. He's trying to intimidate us.
Well, it won't work. Why isn't DS Cohen slung him out yet?
We all stick together, that lot.
You're going to take the word of a teenager?
Me daughter?
Over that of your boyfriend.
I've got to keep an open mind. Teresa, we got a minute. What's the situation with John Paul?
That's great news. Let me know when you get some fingerprints. In case anyone's interested, we found the murder weapon.
Are we supposed to believe anything that comes out of your gob?
It's at the lab now. So you better get your story straight. Because it looks like George's killer is about to be unmasked.
It must feel nice. Being out in the fresh air. Was it terribly traumatic in prison?
I don't know. I didn't really feel anything. I haven't felt anything since George died. Why would someone do that to him? I mean, who?
Don't upset yourself. George was physically and psychologically abusive. It wasn't down to you to save him. He needed help to get away.
You were the only person who saw him for what he truly was.
I could see you in so much pain because I felt it right here.
Why are you both upset? Is it because George is gone?
Sort of, yeah. You know the reason why I had to go away for a while, don't you? And you know that George used to hurt your daddy.
I should have protected you from him.
No, that's not your job, mate. No, I tried to make him stop, but I should have asked for help.
Why did he do it?
Honestly, mate, I have no idea. You see, sometimes people they tell you that they love you and they make you feel like it's real. But love is being happy and warm. Like you've swallowed a big ball of sunshine.
That's how I feel about you.
OMG, same. You promise me that if anyone ever makes you feel like that, you walk away, all right?
I promise.
Good lad. Right. Why don't you show me some of the tricks on that bike, eh?
Does a part of you still love George?
It's Goldie. They found the murder weapon.
How many times have I got to repeat myself? I dropped John Paul's case. Look, I thought we'd gone over this. Your lack of belief in me is really beginning to sound the death knell on our future happiness.
I hate it when you talk like that.
Or is it just deflection?
For what?
It is the real reason you can't stop banging on about our ex. You killed his boyfriend, eh? Worried the newly found murder weapon's gonna be riddled with your DNA?
So you do seriously believe that, do you? I am not the only one who had it in for George!
See, it hurts, doesn't it? When the person you care about questions their trust in you. Why are we even together if you think I'm capable of lying to your face?
Because... it was Leah. She was really convinced, so...
And believe what you want. I'm done with this childish behaviour.
No. Maybe she got it wrong.
I'm not in control.
Don't you think I've got a right to know? Goldie told me that you found the murder weapon. Whose fingerprints are on it?
I think Miss McQueen is getting ahead of herself.
She found out from PC Smith that you falsely accused me of murdering my boyfriend, okay? The least you could do if you've got an ounce of decency is tell me who actually did it.
PC Smith has been suspended, and there has been no discovery of any weapon.
But...
Just stop interfering with the case. Go home and let us do our job. And if you want my advice, stay away from PC Smith.
Thought you were dancing after school.
That's for the 80s dance recital. And considering I have no costume, it's not for me.
You know I'm brassic at the minute.
It's fine. What's for tea?
Chicken nuggets. Hang on. I just want to say sorry for snapping this morning. I know you were only trying to look out for me.
Have you broken up with James then?
No.
What about John Paul?
Leah, I think you got a little bit confused. James didn't help John Paul get released, or whatever you think you heard him tell the McQueens.
I know what I heard.
Right, you need to let this go.
You think I'm lying, don't you?
I didn't say that.
He's the liar.
But you know what, just get to your room.
This is so typical of you. As soon as you get a new fella, me and Lucas can do a running jump.
That's not true.
You have been with James for less than 5 minutes, and you're already taking his word over mine. What sort of dad does that?
Leah.
Other dads would believe their kids.
Right, you know what, that is it. You are grounded.
But other dads aren't stupid, racist bullies. It was so much better when you weren't around. God, I wish you still weren't.
Stay. What's up?
Nothing. Just knackered from cleaning.
It's a fella, innit? Look, I know what them signs. I have cried them tears 1,000 times.
It's all Leah. She hates me.
Of course she does. She's a teenager.
I mean, like, proper hates me. She accused me of being a rotten dad. She brought up all the racist stuff as well. I know she's still scarred from it, but I am trying.
Look, she's not just going to wipe that from her memory. I used to get called all sorts in school until they realised that I had a right hook and a big gob. I mean, I know it's not the right way to deal with bullies, but it worked for me.
You know how sorry I am, don't you?
Of course I do, and Leah does. Look, it sounds to me like she's just lashing out. Whenever I used to be mad at my mum, I used to slag her knitting off. I wish that was the only thing that I needed to be worried about with her.
I suppose you are right. It is about a man. She hates James.
James? Hey. Look what we got him. Just a little thank you know, for getting our John Paul released.
For what?
Yeah, Teresa and him found out that that copper was Ben. If it weren't for James, our John Paul would still be locked up.
So he did lie to me.
I mean, me and my family owe him absolutely everything. Ugh, just gives you shivers, doesn't it? Hey, and whoever did kill George, they'll be bricking it now because they found the murder weapon and it could be someone from the village.
Buddy, do you want some help with your maths homework?
Hey, what's that? That's not maths homework.
It's me and you, with sunshine in our bellies.